title, Dragon Point History.
Standing here at Dragon Point puts us directly across from the highest cliff in Colorado, the Painted Wall. From here, many of the cracks, crags, nooks, and crannies become very evident, and this was the spot many young people in the 1960s stood to study the cliff before attempting a climb.
Gray and white rock wall.
Legendary climbing pioneer Leighton Koehr had established climbs on their arêtes, or corners, at both ends of this famous cliff in the early 60s. But he had also made several attempts to climb the main face of the wall, each of them unsuccessful.
Dotted yellow lines.
The wall is laced with stripes of pegmatite, igneous rock that breaks into large chunks. But most of the cliff is made of metamorphic gneiss, which is fractured and brittle. One climber described this type of rock as petrified breadcrumbs. The overhanging ledges and lack of continuous cracks added to the difficulty of such a climb. Those considerations and the sheer height of the wall, over 2,200 feet, means that climbing this wall would require days rather than hours, and climbers would have to bring all of their supplies with them.
Gray rock wall with white stripes.
Most early attempts to climb a painted wall started out on the grassy ledge that lies to the right and below the widest stripes that are together, called the dragons. Techniques in those days included drilling holes into the rock that were used to hammer in bolts, a technique that today is prohibited. The rock was so tough that several attempts at the wall were abandoned because the rock chewed up the drill bits. By 1971, the painted wall had become one of the primary objectives in big wall climbing around the country.
Mountain peak in clouds.
Bill Forrest and Chris Walker had become friends climbing treacherous routes on Long's Peak in Rocky Mountain National Park. They made a detailed study of the wall and carefully chose a route that would lead them up a series of indentations or dihedrals and would pass just to the left of the nose of the dragons. The top dihedral, near the mouth of the upper dragon, was called Death Valley. Although neither of them had a great deal of climbing experience at Black Canyon, they set out in late April.
Painted wall shrouded in clouds.
At first, they were plagued with poison ivy and snowstorms, but the two slowly worked their way up the wall. A short distance up, Forrest accidentally pulled a 30-pound block loose.
Climber on rock.
He couldn't hold it after it hammered his thigh, and it nearly slammed Walker's head as it fell past him to the rubble below.
Climber above white rock.
Higher up, Walker experienced a similar problem. Walker was leading when he dislodged a large rock. He eased it onto his lap for a moment, but the weight felt like 100 pounds. He yelled to Forrest to tell him of his problem and let it go.
Climber with glasses.
Forrest squeezed against the cliff, thinking the boulder would take him out as it tumbled toward him. The next thing he knew, it exploded in a crash only a few feet below him.
Painted wall, black and white.
Now, 4 days into their effort, they reached the ceilings or overhangs at the top of Death Valley, the only obstacles between them and the top.
Smiling climber.
Forrest took the lead, setting pins or pitons to embrace the rope as well as he could, yet none of them were set so they could hold his weight. Some 2,000 feet above the river, a tiny crack was just beyond his grasp.
Fingers gripping rock.
Out of options, the two finally agreed to try the drill. The shallow hole, the only one they drilled on the climb, allowed a bolt to go in only halfway, but it was enough, and Forrest could see the top. Walker soon followed, removing the bolt as he went by.
Men smiling in front of cliff.
The pair had found the most difficult climbing route in Black Canyon, and had completed it in the face of great danger where a retreat down the cliff was impossible. This nearly boltless climb has been called one of the landmark achievements in American big wall climbing.
Towering cliff walls, river with rapids and boulders. Text on screen. Non-MPS credits, select photographs, courtesy of Bill Forrest and Jeff Aki.